like I care.
Hey folks, what's going on? Welcome back. Happy Saturday. We are here to return to Life is Strange Before the Storm, trying to get this finished before Double Exposure comes out at the end of the month. Might already be out for the glitterati, the bourgeoisie, who have already ordered the super deluxe ultimate fucking Square Enix Moogle version of the game. Me, I'm gonna wait until we can all play it together, the masses. So, because I totally can and would buy the expensive one. It's just that it's a solidarity thing. So that's my angle. Before we get into that, we have some trivia from Den Dorado. This is just one of those world-based trivias. I always like these. This is all about the a fairy tale kingdom. In a fairy tale kingdom. That's right. So we're gonna get the code for that up on screen here. Oh God! Apollo literally warned me that it was gonna do that, and I wasn't ready at all. Jesus. PCSX2, yeah, it still works. The name never worked. I really don't want to be ops with the people who made that, but God, can we just call it anything else besides PCSX2? It reads like a fucking error code. What's up, Baka? A date?
Two shots.
What's happening? Baka? That's fun. Congratulations on the date, Baka. thank you. I hope your conference went well, by the way. I feel like we haven't checked in a bit. I hope you're doing all right. God, I love that ice cream sandwich, Bluk. I kind of want one now. That would hit. There are English modded ISOs. But I mean, like, the name of the program. That's what I'm talking about. Unless that's what you're talking about and I'm dumb. Good, I'm glad. God, this is so festive. PCSX. Yeah. I'm just gutted by that name. It could be brilliant, but instead I'm gutted. Dendrod, I'm sorry, you kind of got screwed. This got scheduled on a Before the Storm date, so not as many people are going to get to see the Blukka, and they deserve to, but I put it on a Saturday, and here's my logic for what goes on the Saturday slot. It's whatever I think is, like, the most general, you know? You might notice I never put, like, the really specific trivia topics on Saturdays, at least if I can afford it. Because I feel like I was traumatized once, like, we were playing Sly or something, and I put, like, Day's Synthesis Part 2 on a Saturday, and it was, like, three of us just having a terrible time all together. Sure, Vodka, sure. And this is not, listen, I have no illusions about the reality of when people tune into what the Kingdom Hearts guy is doing, you know? I'm not mad at anybody. I'm just saying, like, I gotta, you know, generally anticipate, visualize the future and be like, okay, realistically, fewer people are gonna show up to this one at all, so I need to make the trivia something that will appeal to more people. I don't know why I'm closing my eyes. Why am I doing this as I explain myself? Because I'm actually really tired. I'm on a complete degenerate schedule. I woke up yesterday at 3:30 p.m. and I went to bed at 11 a.m. and I really just worked all day. I got dinner with regular GF. Did we do something else too? What did we do before dinner? Oh, we did an escape room. Yeah, that was fun. We crushed it. It was actually probably the best we'd ever done. God, my brain is bad because I was like, what did I do yesterday? I don't know, I rolled out of bed like just in time for this. I mean, you're kind of right, Splash. The room theme was wizards. It was kind of like a Harry Potter ripoff. Last time we went to that one, it was a mafia theme. They were both kind of easy, these ones. Now, maybe we're just getting better at them. That's probably, like, the seventh one we've done. Oh, you're right, Ace. Let me move that. I think I put it there before I had committed to playing Before the Storm, so there wasn't going to be, like, a great time to do it. But I will remove that. I'm gonna miss this song now, even though it scared the shit out of me. Like, when it goes away, I'm gonna be bummed. But then we get the Christmas one, and that one's fun. Bum, 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 bum. Yeah, let's remove that so we don't get confused. There we go. Game breakdown from Phoenix, new episode today, the Wonderland episode. I got to watch it early because we're homies, but it's out there for the public now. Now I feel like a hypocrite based on the thing I said about waiting for the double exposure to release to the masses. It won't let you do sparkles like in Twitch chat. That's misogyny, I think. Alright, I guess I'll get in here. I'm gonna crush you all. Kingdom of Corona, probably one of my favorite KH3 worlds. It's pretty good. It's either that or Caribbean, I think. That's what I've decided. Or Scala. It could be Scala. The final world, even, just with those two rooms. I'm like, ooh, those are some good rooms. Even though one of them is blank, you know? Just the atmosphere kicks me right in the ass. Alright, I'm gonna be Rona Patty. Bing. Oh, can't spell. Come on now. No, yeah. Like, KH3, I think. I said this the other day, like, it has really good worlds, but I don't know if there's, like, one that, like, stands head and shoulders above the rest. But I don't really know if KH2 has that. I mean, I guess it does in the way of, like, its original worlds. They stand head and shoulders above the Disney ones. KH3, like, has Twilight Town, which is, like, you know, three rooms. But then the other, like, yeah, all the original worlds are so small. Where it's, like, the graveyard, which is comparatively smaller and blanker. So I think that's my problem with 3, is, like, there's not an obvious favorite. And then, you know, when I think about the Disney worlds exclusively in 1 and 2, like, I don't know if one of them really stands out above the others. I guess Timeless River in 2. But in 1, like, they're all pretty solid. I would probably go Halloween Town, but that's just kind of, like, because I like the movie. Yeah, I think Caribbean is really impressive. I think it's, like, I think it's the best of the two, like, open world styles that KH3 does. They're both, like, a little empty feeling at times, like, even though they're so big, but I think Caribbean does it a lot better. I mean, there's really nothing to do in San Fran besides, you know, look for chests and lucky emblems, which I guess is the truth for Caribbean, but there's just, like, more variety, weirdly enough, like, even though it's just islands. San Francisco is just, like, big, tall buildings. And that's, I'm kind of being, you know, reductive with that, but I just feel like it sticks out more to me, the Caribbean. Yeah, and honestly, like, even the underwater stuff in Caribbean, that's, you know, it's not painful. Flash Tracer is cool, though. I'll give San Fran that. Boom, boom. But yeah, I still haven't done, you know, KH3 World Ranking. I'd like to, but I'm almost, like, paralyzed by choice. Like, I don't know what to how to order them. And then it's just weird when you have, like, the little worlds that get in the way. I kind of want to group them all together. If I grouped all the little worlds together, they would win. The experience of just those three Twilight Town rooms, plus Final World, plus Scala. Maybe Keyblade Graveyard drags it down a bit, but... Okay, sorry, yap. Let's do trivia. This is all about Kingdom of Corona by Denderado. Here we go. Oh, stealth typing. Oh man, see, if I had known, I completely butchered that. butchered or botched. I typed like some nonsense. That's right, Bach, it's all for you. Ever After. There you go. Number 2. Hopefully no more typing. Ooh, gotta be that, right? Who is the first Kingdom of Corona character that Sora encounters? Yeah, it's Flynn. Who, by the way, I butchered that, got 2 votes in the popularity poll. Which is crazy to me. Tied with Buzz. They both got 2. the least popular party members in a numbered title. And they would be least popular overall if it wasn't for Prince Philip, who you have for, like, a minute in BBS. I don't even know how that happens. I feel like that's just... I don't know. Maybe they're not as popular as I thought just generally. Like, I thought people would just like Toy Story and Tangled enough to put those guys higher up, but two people. Number three. You can still join. There's still time. I feel like it's this. Which of these quotes is not said in Kingdom of Corona? Yeah, I almost picked yellow thinking it was Olympus, but this is at the very end of Corona when they're, like, standing on that overlook. And Maleficent goes, "It is etched." Green is the, "Just like your face," which some people told me was a bad line. I'm like, you have no whimsy, no joy. And then red is probably Marley talking to Sora. This, I don't know where it's from. But it makes sense because, like, who would be talking to who here? I'm not sure where it's from. It kind of sounds like a KH1 quote. Number four. Yeah, generic darkness line. Gotta be this. Which of these songs never plays in Kingdom of Corona? Little Lovely Moments, Swingin' Free, The Fun Fair, or Happy Hair Day? It was kind of giving, like, Riku Ansem talking to Maleficent, yeah. Yeah, The Fun Fair is the Prankster's Paradise field theme from Dream Drop. This is Corona Field, this is Corona Battle, and this is, like, a cutscene track. Might play in, like, a gameplay moment. I don't think so, though. Number five. Gotta be this, right? Which of these voice actors voice a Kingdom of Corona character? We have Kelsey Lansdowne, Ross Thomas, Idina Menzel, or Rob Paulsen? Yeah, I'm assuming Kelsey here is the Mandy Moore replacement for Rapunzel. Idina Menzel's Elsa, and then I know Rob Paulsen. I can't think of who he is in KH. Same with, I mean, I don't know Ross Thomas, so I'm not sure on those ones. Number six. You know Rob Paulsen. He's Carl Weezer. Oh, what is wrong with me? Why did I take so long on that? Good job, everybody. The name of Mother Gothel's emblem, Heartless, is the Grim Guardianess. That's Big Fish. That is the Ven Tree from Dwarf Woodlands. And the Mean Maiden, I want to say, is the Union Cross Lady Tremaine one. Number seven. He's Pinky, yep. I think it's that. Which song plays in the Grim Guardianess boss fight? I don't think I've ever seen this concept art. Eye of the Storm, Skyward Striker, Anger Unchained, or Tension Rising? Ba-na-na-na. Yep, Anger Unchained, that's like your deep end of KH3, although they do play the deep end for Rock Titan. Eye of the Storm is a Davy Jones track. Skyward Striker is King of Toys. They get used besides just there. Tension Rising is a bunch of nobody stuff. Number eight. great question. You know, I saw Tangled once. Okay, I thought it was that. The Stabbington Brothers is who Marluxia takes the place of in the Tangled story. I don't remember these other guys, really. I hardly remember the Stabbington Brothers. Man, I watched it after KH3 as well, but it's just, like, completely, completely drawn a blank. Number nine. That is this one. The most popular of the Flans, actually, according to the survey. Which of the Flantastic Seven is located in the Fairy Tale Kingdom? You got cherry, orange, grape, or honeydew? Yep, it's orange. It's the picture-taking one. Cherry is Olympus, grape is Arendelle, and honeydew is San Fran, I think. 10. Sorry. Sorry, Denderado. What is the minigame information for the orange flan? Oops. I know, 13 participants. Could have been Organization 13 of Trivia. We could have had a Shion, but... There you go. Yeah, I kind of blew that one. Sorry. Number 11. 3 points for me, though. Oh, God. I'm assuming this. Which battle gates are in Kingdom of Corona? Oh, actually... It's gotta be one of the earlier sets here. I always forget if Corona's before Toy Box. Must not be. Fuck. So it must be like 1 and 2 and 3 are spread between Olympus and Twilight Town, 4 and 5 in Toy Box, and 6 and 7 in Corona. Yeah, of course Toy Box is first. It's more exciting to go to first than Tangled. 12. What's up?
Me?
Yeah.
King.
Oh my God.
early birthday.
Regular GF got one of these at it was like a retro store.
Such a cool store.
Yeah. It had like old games and movies and just memorabilia. Damn it! I said 12. 12 lucky or 9 lucky emblems. And she got one of these and it's just like a little, what would you call it, like a stress squeezy fidget guy?
Yeah.
That's probably not the official name in the patent, but
the official.
I love these.
It's a Nido Nice Cube.
A Nido Nice Cube. I was like, oh, you gave me one for my birthday. So I got an early birthday present.
Woo-hoo!
Woo-hoo! Thank you. Yeah. Jungle Wine says, hi, we love you, Queen.
Hi! Thank you. Love y'all, too.
She's got her nails done. You want to show your nails off?
Oh, yeah.
Look at that.
Red chrome besties.
The red chrome. You were matching your shirt before you changed.
I know, I always do that.
Yeah.
By accident.
Very wise.
Well, actually, no, I think I low-key do it on purpose.
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's subconscious.
Because when I got my nails done last time, I wore a color like this.
Yeah.
Which was like what
it was
I had.
Brown, yeah.
And then before that, I had on my yellow strawberry shirt, and that's when I had my yellow nails.
Wow. See? The passion for fashion.
Of course. Ooh, brats.
Hell yeah, dude. All right, I gotta continue on.
Good luck.
All right, thank you. 13. Isn't that crazy? Ooh. I feel like it's this? Yeah, what are the odds that I would meet someone named Regular GF? It's like we were literally made for each other. So yeah, the screen transition is the Corona Suncrest. I almost said the tower, but that'd be kind of overkill, right? A little on the nose. All right, 14. Also, Birdie, thank you for the 6 months. Life sure is strange. Appreciate that. This I remember because I said it in a video. Sora defeats the Lich in the Kingdom of Corona platform and releases the heart of Mickey, Goofy, Donald, or Aqua. Well, Mickey, Goofy, Donald, and Aqua are searching for clues in a fairy tale kingdom. Right, because Mickey is the king, so he's in the kingdom. 15. There you go. No idea. How many points do you need to score on the Festival Dance minigame to get the Festive Dancer Trophy? 20, 40, 70, or 90,000? Nah. 70? That's so random. Alright. 16. What is the name of this Heartless? The Cursed Coach, the Assault Rider, the Wild Bruiser, or the Chaos Carriage? Could fit this one, all of them. Yeah, Cursed Coach is the Aqua Castle of Dreams boss, Assault Rider is the Land of Dragons Centaurs, Wild Bruiser is the big gorilla guys from BBS Neverland. 17. That's Margaret. Ooh. Gotta be. Oh no, I don't know. In which event was the Tangled World revealed for KH3? D23 2017, TGS 2016, E3 2015. Yeah, I got it. I almost said TGS 2016, but that felt late. Okay. 18? Yeah, we knew about Tangled for a long time. Which is the only Kingdom of Corona song available in Melody of Memory? Got a 50-50 chance here. The field or the battle theme? Just kind of a hint, if you can think of how it goes. Yeah, it is the field theme. Happy Hair Day. Alright, 19. Well, sort of biffed that one as well. A fairy tale kingdom is how Kairi refers to Kingdom of Corona. She calls everything else by name, including Toy Box, which it feels like she shouldn't know, and neither should the characters, that the world is called Toy Box. Because, like, what does that mean? You know? It's too, like, self-aware. You mean, like, the street that Andy lives on? Like, they know that's called Toy Box? That makes no sense. It's like a non-diegetic name, so to speak. Alright, final question, 20. Yeah, they don't even go in the toy box. Gotta be this, right? Feels too obvious, though. What is the name of the trophy that you get after finishing Kingdom of Corona? Where the bells toll, Act of True Love, Honest Soul, or Happily Ever After? Yeah. Act of True Love is gotta be Frozen. And then this sounds like something from Hunchback. Maybe green is like a Maestro one or Pancho's Paradise. Okay, let's see our results in third place. It's me, God, I can't fucking catch a break. Just James and Ace Productions. Congratulations. I haven't won in a long time, I think. I thought I crushed that, but I guess I was slow on the draw. I think I did miss one or two. We have Once Upon a Brian in fourth, and Fairy Tale Shroom in fifth, and for our top 10, Stupid Computer, I'm Very Bored, Nox, Apollo, and Esor. Thank you so much to Den Dorado for making this for us. Appreciate that. I'm going to say this was 67%. Wow, I am so good. I'm goated, actually. All right, we have the Spottle. Yesterday was AC/DC. Today's is Gorillaz. Fuck. Fuck. All right, early 2000s. Early 2000s. It's solo Justin Timberlake. Fuck. Okay. Even more popular, 2003-4-5. Solo. So they're probably still around doing stuff. Solo male pop star debut 2003-4-5. In America. Should be easy. They're incredibly popular, it seems like. And I'm drawing a complete blank. Who is like Justin Timberlake, but more popular? I think I need help already. It can't be Justin Bieber, because that would be Canada. He also started later than the range. Dan Bop's favorite artist? Oh, bad on me for not knowing my patrons. Bruno? Did he start that early? Maybe he did and I just didn't know of him. No. Alright, we're less popular than Bruno, but more than Justin. Yeah, I think I'll take a hint. Dan Bop's favorite artist? Have they ever mentioned that? I mean, at least near me. Usher is actually earlier than you would think. Oh, Pitbull? Actually, that feels familiar now. Why do I feel like I've heard Dan Bop talk about Pitbull? I guess I just wasn't thinking of, like, Pitbull as someone who started that early. For me, like, he wasn't someone in my cultural, not my, you know, my personal consciousness until probably, like, the 2010s. multiple times. All right. Okay, there you go, Pitbull. We're going to move on over to Before the Storm. Bye, Bot People.